very excited to introduce the Promise Bill to encourage students to gain a higher education community college for 2 years of free tuition.
The DREAM Act is important. I am the daughter of Haitian immigrants. The immigrant population is a hardworking population. And if we give them the opportunity to excel, would add value to our community. As we know, many hospitals, CEOs, and administrators are being paid high salaries. We need to look at how we're going to reallocate the overall budget to allow quality care. In addition to that, in my district, nursing is the number one profession that is sought. However, jobs are not available. This bill, which codifies with the federal law of Roe versus Wade and also gives proper measures in keeping a woman from any harm. This has to do with all women having a choice.
The weak rent laws that we have has been very problematic to New Yorkers, especially in my district, Flatbush, Brooklyn, where, you know, thousands or even millions of New Yorkers are being pushed out illegally, priced out illegally out of their homes, which obviously impact the rate of the homelessness that we're facing in New York City.
Last week, I introduced Bill number A9074, which amends the real estate property tax law to include MWBE participation goals. I represent Flatbush, Brooklyn. And as the chair of the Oversight Committee and Minority-Owned Business Enterprises in the Assembly, I will continue to stand with the Women Builders Council, all the women and minority engineers and construction owners, to see that minority and women-owned businesses get their fair share of the economic American dream. I want to commend the sponsor, Mr. Kim, for introducing this bill that tracks demographic information on immigrant population that has been probably quite ignored for some time.
We are here establishing the Haitian Studies Institute. I stepped in 3 years ago and I wanted to make sure that it had a home. So I pushed and worked with my local elected officials, with the college, to make sure that the Haitian Studies Institute was here.
I rise today in support of this bill on paid family leave, which truly promotes good family values. What's barbaric? It's not mixed martial arts to me. It's more so around gun violence and the many guns that are killing our children out in the streets, in particular, children of color.
Mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find. Some loving here today. Yeah. Father, Father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate.
I must say that when I ran for public office, I did so in the hopes that the people would trust me in the work for the people. And I truly agree that this bill is the first step in the right direction in addressing that we need to reform campaign contribution in closing the LLC loophole, as well as reforming outside income.
Part of it is to get people civically engaged. Very often, our people have a lot of needs, but they don't know how to get their issues addressed. You know, being a voter registrant, voting, and participating in the civic engaged activities in the community.
A resolution we had recently introduced around the missing girls in Chibok, Nigeria. Over 276 girls are missing. And as we wear our red, we think of these young girls, our sisters, and we want to bring our girls back.
You can call on me on any services that I can possibly help you with. My office will be somewhere near the Flatbush Junction.
Pastor would say, we need to think about being king-minded. With an eye toward the future, I pray that together we fight for the New Yorkers, for economic justice, for civil rights, social reform. Because if we don't speak out, no one will. And we want to make sure that Dr. King's sacrifices and his dream becomes a reality.
I must confess that That dream that I had that day has at many points turned into a nightmare. Now, I'm not one to lose hope. I keep on hoping. I still have faith in the future. But I've had to analyze many things over the last few years, and I would say over the last few months. I've gone through a lot of soul-searching and agonizing moments, and I've come to see that we have many more difficult days ahead, and some of the old optimism was a little superficial, and now it must be tempered with a solid realism. And I think the realistic fact is that we still have a long, long way to go, and that we are involved in a war on Asian soil, which, if not checked and stopped, can poison the very soul of our nation.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, glory,
glory,
glory.
Now the war is not